Hey, this is Tom Jacobs from tdjacobs.com. I'm an evolutionary astrologer and also an energy worker and a channel. And at tdjacobs.com, you will find over the last decade's worth of tools I've been developing for years to help you advance whatever phase you're in to become the person you are meant to be. And some of those include Chiron, the Chiron Natal Report, the Chiron book, and the Chiron audio course. The book's a transcription of that audio course. Those are all there, as well as Living Myth and the Living in the Present Tense Natal Report. This video is about Chiron natally in the sixth house. Let me just first put your attention on the fact there are two, there's an overview video on Chiron that I published recently before I started doing this house series, and also Chiron and Energy Management. Those two videos, about 35, 38 minutes, cover a lot of my approach to Chiron that's unique. So you might want to watch those before you really understand what I'm saying in this video about energy management and energy sensitivity and hypersensitivity. I look at Chiron as the energy antenna within a person. If the sun function is how do I develop a healthy ego? How do I shine? If Mercury is perception function, and Uranus is the individuation or developing freedom function, you know, breaking off the chains that bind. Chiron would be the energy sensitivity function or energy antenna. So you experience energy from others and in the world around you, and you feel emotions as a result. And that's what everybody's Chiron indicates, the energy antenna. We think of ourselves as minds with bodies or bodies with brains, and oh yes, the pesky heart, but we're sensitive to energy. We're actually consciousness that exists across time. We're sensitive to energy. We are energetic beings. Everything's about energy and emotion. So with Chiron, wherever you find it in the chart, a person will be hypersensitive to how others react to him or her, making mountains out of molehills about these reactions. So you have an idea, somebody grumbles, and you say, oh, it's terrible, I should never have said anything, because part of you fears rejection for doing this thing. You learn this as a baby, and the baby got imprinted. So you have an inner infant with you who temporarily takes over when that fear gets triggered. A lot of people with Chiron don't, until I tell them the story or they read the book, don't understand why they feel so helpless when this gets triggered. It's because a part of you that has no tools or understanding, part of you that is focused solely on trying to feel safe, but doesn't feel safe and doesn't feel loved and supported and embraced, that part takes over. I used to think of it in terms, I still think of it in terms of you're driving your car down the road, emotionally speaking, and you say, oh yes, we're going to Jonesville. Great, we're going to whatever, Smithtown. And part of you in the back seat's like, well, nope, can't do, and they reach over and steer you off the road. All you realize is something went wrong and you're staring at a bunch of corn, like you're in a cornfield. You have no idea what happened. It's like the inner infant takes over to try to keep you from going toward disaster and getting rejection because you need safety, you need support, you need to know you're loved. That's a core Chiron thing. So with Chiron in the sixth house is the house of daily routine. It's about taking responsibility for things. It's the parts of life where we learn through teamwork, where we learn through backburnering or temporarily shelving egoic desire in order to be useful and helpful. So the sixth house is about service, all the parts of life that are about hands-on service, detail-oriented work, you know, process development, project management, all kinds of things like this. And it's about food and exercise as far as how they contribute to health. Not the first house experience of here's my body, but the sixth house, what's going on? Let me monitor processes. Let me be detail oriented and fix things. That's the sixth house motivation, to fix things. So Chiron in the sixth says, when you try to fix things, when you're part of a team, when you see a better way to do something and you introduce it, somebody's reaction may make you feel rejected. Again, you're hypersensitive to how others see you. Now, teamwork is one level, but another level is being an employee. Sixth house involves unequal relationships, both bosses and employees of various levels. So you might see a unique way to do something. Chiron's always about seeing uniqueness. You might see a different process, a different workflow issue. You might see something unique where you can bring to the table and it would improve something, but you might fear being rejected for it. Chiron in the sixth says that you do things in different ways as well. You approach responsibility differently, but also you work on manual tasks. You will do them in a different way. You might organize and analyze things in a unique way that's different than how everybody else does. So when people say to you, we're not supposed to do it that way, you might feel the threat of rejection or something's wrong with how you're doing it. So you show up with a uniqueness and you're trying to figure out how to express uniqueness while not getting rejected. So one of the major things to talk about here, referencing the little kid idea, the inner kid, you know, driving off the road, is that you have to become the kind of parent for yourself now, parent for your inner kids, that you wished you had when you were a little kid. So make a list of what you wish your parents could have been for you or done for you and become and do those things now to take the onus off them so that this inner infant isn't waiting for someone else to validate him or her. So how things get done is what we're talking about. Think about babies' behavior, organization. Babies might be learning to put their toys back at certain ages, might be learning, you know, they're going to spell things with the blocks differently when they're learning language, little kids, toddlers. But there's a different way of approaching organization and different things like that. And so you might have been corrected, but you were hypersensitive, so you took it as a rejection or the threat of the loss of love. So you must become self-validating when it comes to how you do things, how you function in a team, how you actually get things done. With Chiron in the sixth, you may feel that your work isn't worthy. You might have an issue doing assignments on time or following rules if part of you fears that you're not going to be loved and accepted if you do it wrong. So the fact in the sixth house is that everybody makes mistakes and everybody learns through trial and error, but you might be hypersensitive to the judgment and criticisms of others as if you're not good enough just because you made a mistake. So with Chiron in the sixth house, there's also this level of food and diet and supplements and the way the body works. Because it's the energy antenna, you're going to have a unique ability to tune in to minute processes in your body. When you're willing to accept that you're unique and you're not afraid of being rejected, that opens up the resourcefulness and cleverness of Chiron. And there's a deep level of sensitivity to what's going on in your bodies and your body, your organs, your body, your musculature, your skeleton, your nerves. You'll have a deep level of visceral sensitivity to how adding this supplement or eating this food and not eating that food, how it changes. So one of your skills and gifts is in listening to the body change in those ways and making constructive choices to make things better over time. One of the things that happens in the sixth house is you make minor changes on a daily basis and you watch big change add up over time. If you have Chiron in the sixth, you might not have the faith that you're doing it correctly. So you might not engage. You might fear that you're not going to be consistent or you're not responsible enough to do these things. So again, deal with the inner infant, take care of that energetic sensitivity, that emotional wounding to I'm not good enough or I can't do anything right. When you validate that inner kid, the inner kid can relax and then you can accept that you're simply hyper aware of how others view your work. So with Chiron in the six, you bring a unique perspective. You can embrace that and relax the hypersensitivity by validating yourself so you're no longer afraid others are going to invalidate you, then you can make some progress with some unique Chiron work and living and healing. So to get the full story on this for yourself, get the Chiron Natal Report from tdjacobs.com. It covers house, sign, and aspect, as well as transits and progressions to your natal Chiron and transits of Chiron to the rest of your natal charts. So it's kind of a bulky report, relatively speaking. And also the Chiron audio course and the book, Chiron 2012, The Aquarian Age, The Key and How to Use It. So thanks for your time and energy, and take care of yourself.